What's up, guys? Chaboy D1 here. Today is Tech Review Tuesday. It's on the Black Widow X Chroma, Razer's new keyboard that they just released. I bought this the first week that it came out because I needed to upgrade from my previous $5 Dell keyboard that I've had for like the last 2 years. Never really had a desire to buy it, but I had some extra money, so I said, why not? So you can see the top of the keyboard right there. Your box, we're not going to go into that very much because it's a box. And you don't really care about what's in the box other than the keyboard. There's cable, your little cords and stuff. Let me look at you guys real quick. So yes, you'll notice that I shaved. Look like a child. Won't curse today since this is a review. Yeah. So as you guys saw, this thing is, it's a beautiful keyboard. Let me pop this off. Anyways, so this is the front of the keyboard. Very solid looking. We'll go over it aesthetically first. So it doesn't have like any USB ports or anything around the top. All it's got is just the cord coming out of the top, which is braided. It doesn't kink up very well. It's super sturdy. The first thing that you'll notice about this keyboard is it is freaking heavy. It weighs probably like 5-6 pounds, and that's no joke. Like, it is actually heavy. I was really surprised. Like, almost every time I pick it up to move it, like to play Counter-Strike, to move it closer, it just feels super heavy. It's a Razer product though. It's super quality built. It's heavy. It's really tactile feeling, like the click. I mean, when you click it, like, you can tell it's a mechanical keyboard. Obviously, I've never had a mechanical keyboard before, so I can't really compare it to anything, but let me tell you, I will never go back. I will never not have a mechanical keyboard now, just for the simple fact that it just feels so good. Like, I don't really type on it that much, but it just feels really, really good. Like, to hit keys on it, I play a lot of Counter-Strike, like I said, and I feel like switching through grenades and stuff, something just as simple as that, just feels really good. Everything's super responsive. You never have a misclick that's the keyboard's fault, or that, like, something where you hit a key and then it doesn't work or something. That's yet to happen to me. I've had this for about 10 days, almost 2 weeks now, and this thing is fantastic. I really love this product. Functionality wise, one thing that I do see when I play Counter-Strike that I did in my old keyboard that this one doesn't really work with. So if I'm like running and I want to switch to my knife, I usually just kind of roll this finger forward and use like the very tip of my finger to like hit my knife key, which is 3. And this one, it doesn't work sometimes because, like, if this is held down, then it's hard to get on top of this key. This keyboard, like, the buttons are really far spaced out. I don't know if you can really tell. Like, there's my finger. So, like, if this is pushed down, I have to take it completely off to hit this one. It's hard to, like, hit 2 keys at the same time. I don't know if any of you guys do that or if it's just me. That's something to think about. Another thing is this keyboard kind of sits a little bit high. So usually, for me anyway, on the other keyboard, my wrist usually sat like really low and it was really like angled, or it wasn't very angled. But this one, I feel like I play with my hand up a lot, and it's a comfort thing. For me, it's not that big a deal because usually I play with it because I like to type with the little thingies on the back up. If I can find them. I can't find them. Anyway, I like to play and type with it up, so it kind of like sits up more at an angle. Let's see, is there anything else we can talk about? The Razer Synapse. We could talk about the colors real quick. So the colors on this thing, as you can see throughout the video, they stay the same for like 5, 10, 15 seconds. I haven't really looked at it that much. But it's got like kind of a spectrum thing going on, and that's the default setting, at least for mine it was. And it just changes. It looks really sweet, like in the dark, like off this real shiny BenQ monitor that I've got. I don't know, just all around a solid product. I'm glad that I bought it. I wish it wasn't as expensive. I feel like this is about a $130 keyboard, not a $160 keyboard. Now, I know that sounds really stupid, but the fact that this keyboard almost costs $200 by itself, I feel like a peripheral should not cost that much. But maybe that's just me. I mean, I've got an Astro headset that I've won. I've got a Death Adder that my girlfriend bought me, but that's $60. I don't know. Maybe I just don't know shit about keyboards, but I give it a B+. This is a super cool looking keyboard, super good feeling. If you've got the money, drop it on this thing. It's sweet. It's just a great keyboard for gaming and typing. I've typed a couple things up with this, and it just feels really good. So I hope you guys enjoyed the review. Hopefully we'll be doing more of these soon. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you guys next Tuesday. Hopefully we get something else good in here to review. I might do my Death Adder. Maybe I'll do the Gear VR that I just got. Who knows? But anyway, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks for sticking around. Peace, guys.